Hello students, welcome to Modern Management Technique class. I am Professor Namrata Hampihori from Department of Commerce and Accountancy. We are dealing with second unit, management functions. In that, we are dealing with the organizing concept. In organizing concept, in the previous class, we have started with types of organizing. In that type of organizing, organizations are classified into the four types, that is line, staff organizing, then functional and committee organizing. So we have already done with the two types of the organizing or organization, that is line and staff. In the today's class, we are going to see with the next organizing, that is functional organizing. So when it comes to the small organization or when the organization structure is very small, line and staff organizing are very suitable, wherein you don't have much of the broader departments or the work is not spread. But when it comes to the organization which are functioning in a large number or the capacity of the organization is very big, or the organization is very huge, then those two types are not suitable. For such type of organization, functional organization is considered to be the most suitable one. So what does it mean? As the name itself, functional, that is, divide the task according to its functions. So as there are various functions which are being performed in the organization, such as production department, you have planning department, you have marketing department, sales department, HR department, finance department, right? So divide your work, entire work into these various department and assign their supervisors or the manager who will look after these all work or the task. So here the whole task of the management and the direction of subordinates are divided according to the type they are involved in. So here, according to the F.W. Taylor, for a organization, there should be a specialist or there should be an individual who has some qualities, or he should have 8 of the qualities, right? So here, but it is difficult to find these qualities in one person. So what they have done is here is they have divided that into the production department and then planning department. So under planning department, they have here 4 bosses or the 4 specialists. So here the F.W. Taylor follows the scientific management, that is, he follows the principles of the scientific management, wherein he has divided the managers or the person who should be specialized into the 2 parts. Those are into the planning and the production department. So coming to the planning department here, they are specialized, or the bosses are divided into the route clerk, instruction card clerk, time and cost clerk, and shop disciplinarian. Coming to the first tier is route clerk. Here the boss will lay down the sequence of operations and the instruction the worker is concerned about. That is, he lay down the instructions for the workers and the workers need to follow them. Then in the instruction card, to prepare a detailed instruction regarding the different aspects of the work. So that is, what work should be done and when it is to be submitted. In the same manner, time and cost clerk, it is to send the information relating to their pay to the workers and to secure the proper return of the work from them. That is, what is the time the workers are involved with their work, and according to them and according to their work, what pay must be given to those workers. And the last here is when shop disciplinarian, that is to deal with the cases in case of breach of discipline. So breach of discipline means here, that is when somebody breaks down the rules or doesn't follow the discipline, and in case if there is any absenteeism, then such manager or the bosses will look after such matters, that is why there is a break of discipline and why there is a absenteeism among the employees. So these are the 4 bosses or the specialists who look after in the planning section. Then coming to the four specialists who are into the production line, or these are the specialists or the bosses at the shop level, that is means of production. So gang boss. So gang boss here work is to assemble and the set up tools and machines, and here they have to instruct the workers to make all their personal motions into the quickest and best way. That is, he guides them about, that is, he guides about or give the knowledge about the technicals or the machines which are being set up. Then speed boss will ensure that machines are run at their best speed and the proper tools are used by workers. So here the speed boss will make sure that when the workers are into the like working on the machine, they make a proper utilization of the machine. That is, machine is being handled very carefully with the workers. So this is of the speed boss, wherein he look after the workers. Then here inspector is to ensure that each worker keeps his machine in a good condition and to maintain the cleanliness around him and machine. That is, they see inspector is here to look after or to supervise to see that the machine are maintained in very good condition. And the repair boss here to show the work how to do to the worker. That is, to show the workers how the work is to be performed. So these are the eight specialists or the bosses, wherein they are divided into the two separate parts. Then coming to the features of functional organization. So here the enterprises is divided into the different departments, and under each department the specialists are being placed. Okay, so under, like, you have a finance or the finance department, so the person who is specialized in finance is placed. And then the functional specialist has the authority or the right to give the order regarding their function, whosoever that function is performed in the enterprises, right? That means what here? The person who is appointed as a specialist for this department has a right to take a certain decision. That is, he has been given the authority to look after the overall functioning of the department and take the decision for the betterment of the department. And here, the workers have to receive the instruction from the specialist. That is, the specialists who are involved in this department give the instruction to the workers. So this is how the system follows. That is, the specialized persons will give the instruction to the workers. Then, if anybody in the enterprises has any decision relating to the particular function, it has to be in the consultation with the functional specialist. That is, for every head, there is a specialist or the boss. The subordinates or the workers who are working under him have to concern him or have to speak with him before taking any decisions. Here, then the workers who are working under this specialized, that is the functional features, they have a limited number of functions. That is, they are being instructed with some functions and they have to do only those functions. So here the work of the workers is being restricted. Coming to the advantages of such a functional organization is, as it is like specialized, that is, here there is a division and specialization of the work, it is based on the expert knowledge. That is, every functionary in charge is an expert in his area and can help the subordinates in performing the task better, right? So there are various departments. So when you are appointing a manager or the any expertise in that particular department, you obviously make sure that that person is specialized or experienced or the skilled in that particular field. So when you are appointing someone to the marketing department, you make sure that he has all the best skill to that is best skill in marketing, right? He make the organization make sure that the marketing strategy will work up to the best. Okay, and so there is a division of labor in the planned way and not an incidental. That is, here the workers are placed in the different department in the well systematic manner, that is well planned manner. And in this functional organization, there is a no scope for one man control, right? Because as it is being spread into the different functions, there is a team work which is involved. And here this system will ensure the separation of mental function from the manual function. And this helps mass production by standardization and the specialization. Yes. So as you have a specialist under each department, here there is a standardization or there is a benchmark which is being set, and there is a specialization in the each field. The next, this system will ensure the maximum use of principles of specialization at every point of work. So as the department have appointed the specialist, it will make sure that the maximum use of their specialist or the maximum use of their knowledge is taken for the benefit of the organization. And this organizational offers the greatest scope for expansion as compared to the online, right? So as an online is limited, wherein you have a limited scope, that is the structure of the organization is narrow. Where the structure of the organization is broad, then the functional organization is best suitable. So here, the expert knowledge of the functional manager facilitates better control and supervision in the organization. Yes, so when the authority is given, that is when the decision making authority is given at the each functional, that is each department, then they have the better control and the supervision in the organization. So these were the advantages. Let us look into the disadvantages. So what are the drawbacks of such kind of the organizations? It is unsuitable because it weakens the disciplinary control by making the workers to work under the several different bosses. Thus, functional organization violate the rule of principle of unity of command. Yes. So as the work is divided, or as the task is divided into different departments, there the number of bosses will increase here. So this will again create the confusion who are working in a common line. The question here arises as to whom to report here. So this is a one of the drawback. And next here is the coordinating influence needed to ensure a smoothly functioning of the organization may involve heavy overhead expenses. That is, the overhead, that is expenses which are being involved in such type of the organizing or such type of the functional organization is quite more. Then it is very costly because you have to appoint a specialist for the every department. So you need to pay them more. Again, there are charges when you are hiring them. So again, this method will become the costlier one. Then a functional manager tends to create the boundaries around him and think only in terms of his own department rather than of the whole enterprises. This results in loss of overall perspective dealing with the business problem. Yes, so as a person, when he is given an in charge of a single department to look after, he will only think of that, right? So when a person is engaged in the marketing department, he will see that the products of the organization are best marketed, right? Therein, where if he doesn't look into the cost, what is involved in that marketing, here it affects the finance department, as the funds available with the organization is only known by the finance department. So that becomes here the problem when they are managing the funds. Then it is difficult for the management to responsibility for unsatisfactory results. So here, for management, it is very difficult that when you get the results which are not satisfactory. So these were the advantages, disadvantages, and some of the features of functional organization. So I hope you are clear with this. Here we complete with the three types of the organizing, that is, line organizing, staff organizing, and functional organizing. In the next class, we will be dealing with the last type of the organizing, that is committee organizing.